and I'm just going to talk about my experience in medical school so far, what I've enjoyed, what I found difficult.
Yeah, had a lot on my mind, this thought will render you blind. After I was on my knees praying they would be kind, I was scared to be alone, needed you.
So getting into medical school for the first year was a very exciting time, especially on the first days when you walk into medical school and you're having that talk and they're welcoming you to the medical school. You know, it's all very official and you're feeling like the top select very few. You're feeling very special, like you've made it into an elite club. The moment you get into medical school, you will be fighting to keep your place in medical school. I didn't anticipate that side of things. I thought once I had made it through the application stage, which for me was very difficult, my place was almost guaranteed. But that's really not the reality. From the first year and the first day that we got in, we were really being challenged. The first thing that they did was hand us booklets with learning objectives that were yay big and yay thick, and I'm thinking, oh my goodness, what's going on? Our first assignment was set within the first week. Within the first month, the second assignment was set before the first one was even due. Within that, before 2 months were due, we were told there was an exam coming. So we started in September. We were told there was an exam coming in around November. But after that, you soon realize and get to the pace of things in the way of life. In the first year, you really understand and learn how to prioritize your time. There's no way you can juggle 3 assignments, attend every single lecture, and have a social life and keep a sound mind. So you begin to prioritize and understand what's important to go to, what's not important to go to, what seminars you need to go to. And I would say that was the most challenging part of the first term. The second term, I definitely understood prioritizing. My assignments came first. Lectures took a bit of a backdrop because there was no way I was going to go to all my lectures and do assignments. Within the second term, I was probably down by 50 lectures, if I was going to be honest with you. Easter holiday was damage control. I was catching up on lectures. Now, the other lesson I learned from first year is timing when to start revising and when to start preparing for exams. Because if that's done too late, that can be detrimental to your performance and you're so pressured towards the end. I'm going to admit it was my first year. I was trying to have a good time as well. Maybe the studying social balance was a bit off. And in one of my exams, I think I passed by 0.something%. So that was cutting it close. So yeah, first lesson I learned from first year was it's all about balance. It's all about prioritizing. And you know, this degree is not promised. You know, you can be kicked out if you're not doing the work, you're not keeping up. As the second year progressed, I came in this year, I'm wiser. I'm understanding the obstacles that there are. I'm understanding that medicine is tough. Medicine requires me to prepare. It's not going to be easy. During the summer that followed first year, I started prepping for second year, going through some of the head and neck anatomy that I knew was going to be difficult. I'm speaking to students from the years above. That's another tip that I learned from second year. Speak with students from the year above, understand what works, understand what doesn't work, understand what lectures you have to go to, which are important, understand which lectures are a waste of your time, because there were some lectures, for example, on nutrition, which quite frankly were common sense. Coming from a science background at A levels, you didn't really need to go to them. The exam paper didn't really represent those 10-15 lectures very well anyway, and the questions, you could have answered them without even attending the lectures. So it's important to have connects in the years above that can tell you exactly what you need to focus on, what's important, what hurdles. For me, second year, my head was screwed on from the get-go. I was really trying. And a new method of studying that I found was group studying. I had this friend, we used to meet up every Saturday where we would teach each other subjects. And that way of learning I found was very good. It was very exciting, it was different, it was refreshing. So using that learning method definitely helped me a lot. January exam came, I think I did okay, did well. Our end of second year summer exams, the way how my course works is you get an exam in January, the same content is tested again in June, but with the addition of whatever is learnt in semester 2. So neurology was something that was very heavy in the second year final exam. But I had understood the concepts in the first term, so everything was okay and it went well. Once again, we had an assignment, but obviously I was used to juggling assignment and lectures. Other thing that I realized, especially in the heat of assignments, was attending all your lectures was not always something that you could always do. So I started understanding how to study for myself, how to read books, and how to make notes for myself. And sometimes it was even more efficient than going to lectures. But at this stage, I was not very efficient at it. And I would say, if you're at your teething moments with this, try it out, see how it works. Don't fully go fully in. Maybe try one lecture a week, see how that goes, see how you perform in your exams. If you get more confident, then increase that. Now, moving into third year was a very different year for me. Third year was a clinical year. Third year was probably the year where things started getting a bit shaky. Prior years, first year, I performed okay. Second year, I was a bit better. My performance was even better than first year. Third year, we're getting into a clinical setting. Now, my mindset was more from, I was thinking more about the pathophysiology. It's good to have knowledge about the conditions and how they happen and what causes them. But in time, when it comes to diagnosing, if you can't understand how this condition presents, how it differentiates it from its competitors, and how to investigate this condition, it's not going to work out for you. And that's essentially how I went wrong. Quite frankly, it resulted in me failing the year. I also had other issues that were going on, minor mental health issues, family issues, relationship issues. And these, quite frankly, served as a distraction for this year. And it actually didn't go so well as I'd planned. These things happen. I failed the year because in Newcastle, in the old curriculum, you could only sit the exam once. If you failed your written paper, that's it. You know, you're back again next year. The second time I did third year, I decided to humble myself. Decided to talk to a few friends and, you know, it went a lot better. Moving on to fourth year, I came into fourth year much wiser. I understood how lectures worked. I understood the dance of the game. The first couple of weeks, I attended all my lectures, attended all my seminars. You know, our seminars weeks were very themed. You know, they had a week for cardiology, respiratory, GI. You know, I was trying to stay on top of the game. I'd spoken to my friends. I'd repeated, so I had friends now in the year above. I'd spoken to them. I'd done my research. I understood the requirements of this year inside out. I understood that this was going to be a fast-paced term. There was going to be a lot of lectures and things I needed to learn. So I was on game. I was on point coming into fourth year. Started off doing 5 days a week in the first 2 weeks, stepped it up to 6 days a week. And at the peak, I think I was working 7 days a week, maybe for 2 months. I would say you need to structure the way how you learn to avoid burnout. And that's something that I understood, and that's why I would step it up slowly and gradually. Towards the end, that was my maximum peak. My exam was before Christmas. Usually my exams are after Christmas, so that's why I had to be on the game and on point. Towards midway during the term, I decided going to lectures was not a good use of my time, because my university provides learning objectives. I felt more confident that I could learn the material. So my structure when that I developed going through fourth year was, first thing that I would do is I would write the lecture. I would go through the lecture slides provided. I would create a rough document with those lecture slides, make it into headers, look through the learning objectives, go through that material. What do I understand? Okay, what does not make sense to me? What doesn't make sense to me? I need to research, need to make further notes. And that's how I would do it. And then check the learning objectives. What's not been mentioned? I need to make notes on that. Second step would be watching the lecture. I'd watch the lecture, add in, take away a few things or what the lecture has added that they have not written in the notes. I would add that in. I would see what makes sense and what doesn't. Come back again, maybe after a week, I would come back and look at that lecture again. And this time, this is the final review to edit and add things or take away things and just read over it and just make sure it makes sense. The next time I would come into encounter with those notes would be when I'm revising. And that was the structure I had. Every week was themed being respiratory, cardiology, and GI, and so on. Before the week started, I had something called Anki Notes. So these Anki Notes were passed down to me from a friend. I would go through these question type based cards, these recall question based cards on the week that's coming. So therefore, I would have gone through most of the key terms before the week has come, and I would understand that. I would also do exam questions. And coming to my fourth year exam, I can't lie, when I was in the exam on the first paper, when I opened it, I was like, wow, why have you forsaken me, Lord? I was actually like, bruh, what is going on in this paper? But after that, after I got my exam results, that was probably one of the most solidest first exam performances I've ever done. Really, fourth year was about staying on top of things and really understanding and putting everything I'd learned in my repeat year for third year into practice. And it paid off. And yeah, so moving on to the second half of fourth year was placement. My first placement was pain management. So understanding how pain medication worked, the different groups were having, you know, your paracetamol, having your NSAIDs, having your opiates, having your neuro-based pain medication. My second student selected component placement was on immunology. So understanding allergies. And then, you know, COVID-19 came and put a brake on things. So nothing happened after that. But yeah, that's my journey so far.
Yeah, had a lot on my mind, this thought to render you blind. After I was on my knees praying they would be kind. I was scared to be alone, needed you by my side. I'm from that old school kind of love, we ride or we die. If it's broke, then we fix it, never ditch and depart. I was forced to make a change, baptism of fire. Car crashed back.